God comes,
we become blessed.
Our marriages, they break for a moment, but God comes and restores them. Praise be to Jesus Christ. But they are out there, oh, look at that marriage. Look at that man of God. Look at that woman of God. His marriage has broken. Which God does he serve? Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I saw another person who she is, my friend, is saying that there is a man and a woman who are my neighbors. They keep on praying. They pray on Sunday. They go very early in the church. And they come in the evening with the darkness coming from the church. Yet, their house is being rocked because of rent. Their children are not going to school. Which God are they serving? Praise be to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. They abuse. I know even that rich man, the rich man who was with Lazarus. I know even that rich man was abusing Lazarus. Which God does this man trust upon? I'm walking on chariots. I'm eating well. I wear garments, the purple garments, the kingly garments. Yet I'm not serving the God he's serving. Which God is him serving? Praise be to Jesus Christ. And he abused the God of Lazarus. Only to know the end will be tough for him. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because God has hidden these things from the wise and prudent people. Has hidden these things from the wisdom of the world. That's why the world will always tell you, stop going to church. Stop worshiping that God. Which God are you serving? Stop serving him now. Come and serve our God. Our God will bless you. Our prophet have always seen people getting cursed, and they get. Our prophet has been prophesying for people to receive acres of lands, and they have been receiving. And start serving the true God, and you go back there and connect yourself with other altars of darkness without knowing, thinking that you are still serving the true God. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it is a high time, my brother, my sister, that if you connect yourself to God, you connect yourself fully to God. Without looking back, without looking anybody. If a person is blessed, yes, let him or her be blessed at his moment. You just keep knowing that in due time, my God will bless me, my God will prosper me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's why Abraham kept waiting upon God. It's not Abraham that told Sarah, let me take Hagar and seek for the baby. No, it is Sarah who told Abraham, go and take Hagar and sleep with her. But Abraham wanted to wait upon God. Hallelujah. And for all those years, he waited upon God. But many marriages today are being broken because a woman is not getting a baby or a man cannot produce a baby. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
People are not connecting themselves with God. That's why waiting upon God is difficult in our society. It's difficult even in the church. Pastors are breaking on marriages. Hallelujah. Even bishops. Because now I'm a bishop and my wife cannot get a baby. That does not make me not to go and look for a baby. I will just go and find a baby and I will come back. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that marriage is broken. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People are in prostitution. Prostitution. Yet they are in church. And they claim that they are connected with God. Yet they are in prostitution. We were preaching for the prostitutes some times ago. And they said, aren't you the same pastors that comes and sleep with us here? Aren't you the same pastors that after we have received the money, we come onto your churches and we tithe and offer? And to distinguish ourselves from those pastors, it was a hard thing. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That it made me even to ask for authority from God and start rebuking with authority, telling them we are not the same. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to Jesus Christ. Pastors have abused the altars of God because pastors are breaking their marriage and they go out there sleeping with a prostitute. Because prostitutes, they know pastors. You cannot heed. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You cannot heed, not only a pastor, even you women, you cannot heed from a man. Oh, now that I don't have rent, I will go and seek for a man and sleep with him and he give me some money to pay my rent or to pay for my school fees. That man will know you are a godly person because of your deeds. Yes, you will speak the way you want. But that man will know by your deeds, this person is a godly woman. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We knew, while I was in the world, I knew a godly woman. Even if she dresses like a harlot, I knew this person is a godly woman. It's only that she wants to get something. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was not that good. I was not that good. You know, you people don't know me. You never heard my testimony. You only know a bit of my testimony. I was not that good. I wanted to sleep with all tribes of Kenya. Today I go to a Kisii woman and I ask her, are you a Kisii woman? Yes, I need you. I go for a Luo. Ah, you are a Luo. Yes, I need you. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But in that moment of still sleeping with those women, someone knew that I was a godly person. And she rebuked me. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because I was doing prostitution while still in the church of holiness and righteousness. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That was back in Naivasha, and I was living there. And what made me do all those things? Because I was overcome by masturbation. Masturbation had taken over my life. And now I thought and I knew that the only way to come out of this thing is for me to go and have the prostitute. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Until I knew how to connect myself with God. That's when I was delivered. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I tried many ways to overcome that sin. But it was hard. It was hard. I would cry before God. Oh Lord, I have done it again. I pray that I will not do it again. I repent. And I even vowed, but tomorrow I'm still on it. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is power in connecting yourself with God. There is power of having fellowship with the mysteries of God. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
From the book of Psalms, from verses chapter 1, it is all about the mysteries of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's all about the mysteries of God. Elijah lived by mysteries of God. When you tell a person of the world, Elijah was taken with a chariot of fire, that person will say to you, you are a foolish person. Who does that? Because he cannot understand. He don't know. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When you tell people that Enoch was no more, he walked with God until he was no more, God took Enoch, he will just tell you, oh, he just died like any other person. Praise be to Jesus. You tell a person that God delivered Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in a fire, a furnace that was very hot. That person will wonder, what are you saying? You go to fire, go and try, go and enter into the fire and see if your God can deliver you. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because people don't understand these things. These are secret things. You tell a person that Stephen was stoned to death. He asks you how. How was he stoned? Praise be to Jesus Christ. These things are hidden. You will only understand them if you are connected with God. I said another time I was telling another brother, you know, people right now are going through persecution in Syria. Christians are passing through persecution. And that man was telling me, how did you know that you are going through persecution? How can the church be persecuted? I said, Nigeria, people are dying because of God. And you are asking me, how do I know? Can't you watch the television and see? He said, that is nothing. That is just tribalism. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Because people don't understand what we speak about. People don't understand. You tell people that Peter and Silas, they came out of the jail, out of the prison. But they will wonder, how did that happen? Because they are hidden things of God. We need to go deep, my brother, my sister. You need to go deep. You want to know more about God? Go deep. Sail deeper. You have not yet reached. Go deeper. I am still on the work. I'm moving deeper. I'm seeking to know more before I come out of this world. Those things that those prophets wanted to see, that glory that they wanted to see, that is what I'm working for. I want to see also, how should I come out of this world? Yet I have not seen that glory. Praise be to Jesus Christ. I should work out to see that glory that those prophets wanted to see. I must see that power that is behind the cross. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Paul says, I want to see the power that raises Jesus from the dead. Nobody raised his hand to Jesus Christ to bring him back to life. He died and he arose himself. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. We need to go deep and know much. Know what God wants with us. Know what God wants with our life. Know what God wants with our destiny. And you will only know that by going deeper and deeper. Connecting yourself deep and deep. Let us finish up 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 30 and 31.
First Corinthians chapter 1 verse 30 and 31. Mm. But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, whom of God is made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, that according as it is written, he that glorifieth, let him glory to the Lord.
The word of God says that that no flesh should glory in his presence. But if he are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom. Number one, connect yourself with the wisdom of God. Connect yourself with the wisdom of God, because the wisdom of God is a mystery. Praise be to Jesus Christ. You abide in the wisdom of God. Seek the wisdom of God. You do not understand that wisdom of God. The word of God says that God created everything in his own wisdom. You need to seek that wisdom. Solomon knew, for me to read these people, I need the wisdom of God. I don't need anything. I don't need money. I don't need the gold. I need the wisdom of God. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Number one, wisdom. Number two, righteousness. Number two, righteousness. I'm reading this in the book of Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, 30. Number two, righteousness. Righteousness is a mystery. People of the world don't know what righteousness is. People out there, they don't know what it is because it is a mystery. You need to have fellowship with the righteousness of God. If you don't have the righteousness of God, you will always be counted a sinful person. An ungodly person. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And God says that he knows how to preserve the righteous, the godly people, out of temptation. These are the secrets. So abide in the righteousness of God. Number three, sanctification. Abide in the sanctification of God. Abide in the sanctification of God. You keep telling God, sanctify my heart, sanctify my spirit, sanctify my hands, sanctify my feet. Wherever I have gone that was not your will, sanctify me. Sanctify my body, my soul, and spirit. You live by sanctification. And last three, redemption. Redemption. You seek redemption. You abide in redemption. Because God has redeemed you from everything. Now, my brother, my sister, connect yourself with that redemption of God. Never go back. Never go back. Backward, never forward, ever. In the book of Colossians chapter 2, verses 8. I'm finishing up. I end up with that word, Colossians 2:3. Colossians 2:3. It says, in whom are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge? In whom are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge? So abide also in knowledge, the knowledge of God. Abide in the knowledge of God. Abide in the knowledge of God. Connect yourself with the fellowship of having the knowledge of God. Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And by so doing, you will be fully connected and you will be fully equipped. And God will always be with you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Raise up on your feet as we pray. Before I pray, we may take a moment of time, just ask God to connect you. Ask God to connect you. Ask God to connect you deeply. And to help you to sail deeper in his fellowship and unto his mysteries. Ask God to connect you with him, with his sanctification, with his righteousness, with his wisdom, and with his redemption and his knowledge. Of Jesus Christ, we do pray and believe.
Amen.
Father, in Jesus' mighty name, we give you the glory and honor. Thank you, Jehovah. There is none like you. We give you the glory and honor. Thank you, our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior, for being with us, Lord, into your word. You have taken us into a journey, my Father, of knowing the deep secrets, Lord, and helping us to learn about how to connect ourselves unto your to connect ourselves with you and connect ourselves with your mysteries and secrets, O God. Jehovah, in the name of Jesus, we pray that we abide in your mysteries, we abide in you, in the name of Jesus. You said that if we abide in you, you shall abide in us. We shall become the branches and you shall become the vine. Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, continue being with us, continue helping us in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us not depart from your ways, Let us not fall into the hands of the enemies in the name of Jesus Christ. Go on, Lord, and be with us always, teaching us and leading us, Lord, according to your knowledge and wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. Help us to understand everything, Lord, that you reveal to us, whether in dreams, whether in the word of God, whether on songs, whether on praises, whether on dreams and visions, whether while speaking in tongues. Lord, help us to understand everything that you reveal unto us through your Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for that hour. Thank you for the word. In Jesus' mighty name, we do pray and even believe.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Take your seat. In the name of Jesus. So,